你们好，我是Cecilia. Welcome back to class. In lesson 7, you learn how to say to go somewhere to do something in Chinese. You can use the verb 去 to form sentences now. Amazing job! And this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to say to do something in somewhere or be in somewhere. Okay, let's go! Before we talk about the grammar, let's look at the new words today. 猫, 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 猫 means cat. 小猫 means little cat or kitty. 小 here means small or little. Next is 狗, 狗. And 小狗 means puppies. Does everyone here like puppies? Next one. 椅子, 椅子. The second character here is a neutral tone. 椅子 means chair. 下面, 下面 means under or below. So how do we say under the chair? You can say 椅子下面. 爸爸, 爸爸 means father. 儿子, 儿子 means son. 工人, 工人, 工人 means worker. 工作, 工作, 工作 means to work. 医院, 医院 means hospital. And 医生, 医生 means doctor, the kind that works at the hospital. We've learned these two words, 那 and 哪, in the last lesson. If we still remember, they mean that and which. But if there is a R after them, the meanings actually change. 那儿 means there. Well, 哪儿 means where. The interrogative pronoun 哪儿 is used to ask about the location of somebody or something. Now we come to the most important word for this lesson, and we need you to pay extra attention here. 在, 在. Read after me. 在, 在. 在 can be a verb or preposition. When it's used as a verb, it can be followed by a word of locality and acts as the predicate of a sentence, indicating the location of somebody or something. The structure is subject plus 在 plus a word of locality or direction. For example, 我朋友在学校. My friend is at school. 我妈妈在家. My mom is at home. 小狗在椅子下面. The puppy is under the chair. 在 can also act as a preposition used before a word of locality to introduce the place where an action or behavior takes place. The structure is subject plus 在 plus a word of locality or direction plus verb. 在 in this case is not being used as a verb here anymore because there is a verb in this structure already. For example, 我在朋友家喝茶. I drink tea at a friend's house. 他们在学校看书. They read books at school. Let's see the dialogue. 你在哪? 工作, 我在学校工作. 你儿子在哪儿工作? 我儿子在医院工作. 他是医生, Perform an interrogative sentence to ask about where somebody is. You can use 哪儿 to replace the location word, such as 你在哪儿喝茶？他们在哪儿看书？ Read this dialogue after me. 小猫在哪儿？小猫在那儿。小狗在哪儿？小狗在椅子下面。Do you remember the interrogative particle 呢? It's used to form a question about the situation mentioned previously, such as 我是中国人，你呢? I'm a Chinese, what about you? This time, I'm going to tell you some other ways to use this particle. Basically, 呢 can be used at the end of a sentence to express a questioning tone. For example,你想吃什么呢? What do you want to eat?
你妈妈在哪儿呢?
Where is your mom? You can see the interrogative pronouns 什么 and 哪儿 in these sentences as well. But sometimes 呢 can be used in a sentence without an interrogative pronoun.These kind of sentences usually are asking about the location of somebody or something. For example,
我的小猫呢?
Where is my cat?
我的杯子呢?
Where is my cup? These two sentences have the same meaning with
我的小猫在哪儿?
And
我的杯子在哪儿?
Now let's look at the dialogue. Here are two people talking over the phone.
你爸爸在家吗?
他不在家。
他在哪儿呢?
他在医院。
Okay, that's all for today. Today has been Lesson 9 for HSK Level 1.If you missed some of the lessons previously or you want to review what you already learned again, just go back to the previous videos and check them out one more time. And I will say, I strongly recommend everyone learn these courses lesson by lesson. No skipping ahead. We will have concise linked content in every lesson. Just stay with us and I'm sure you are going to see progress fast. Okay.Don't forget your homework in the next post. Can't wait to see you again. 再见